In the previous videos, you have been focusing on the visual aspect of the sequence. We will now turn our attention to audio. Audio tools in Smoke comprise of a few components. You already know that you can import audio in stereo and in mono. The first component of the audio tools is in the sequence where you deal with audio tracks and audio effects. The second component of audio is the AudioDesk that deals with audio mapping, including mixer inputs and outputs. We'll go through the second component in greater detail in a few minutes. Let's start off in the sequence. You can turn audio waveforms on and off in the timeline. To display your waveforms, select the audio pull-down menu and choose Show Waveform with Effects. To scale the size of your waveforms, you can either click the audio track and drag it down to make the track bigger, or you could go back to the audio pull-down menu and choose Increase or perhaps Decrease the size of the waveforms. Now let's do some audio work. Here I have a piece of audio in the timeline. Let me play this for you. As you can hear, the audio comes in quite sharp and I'd like to fade the sound in. Move the focus point in line with the relevant audio track and navigate to the beginning of the segment. Make sure nothing is selected by clicking on the gray area beneath the sequence. You can click on the transition box in the menu bar and choose Fade. This will apply a transition to the audio segment and you can adjust the length of the fade. The same will apply when fading a clip out. If I want to crossfade two audio segments together, the same principles apply. Navigate to the cut point between the two audio segments and apply a transition between the two segments. Let's listen. So that sounds good. Now I would like the audio level on the middle segment to be lower, so that the audio on the other tracks can be heard. Smoke has a variety of audio tools that you can work directly in the sequence. All you need to do is select the segment, right-click, and add effect. This brings up the effects ribbon for audio effects. Here you can apply audio time warps, noise gate, compression, EQ, audio gain, reverb, delay, and modulation. I'll select the gain audio effects for the segment, and the toolbar will display the gain slider, the auto keyframe button, and an edit button. Pressing play, you can hear the sequence as well as adjust to hear the sound changes in real time. You could also turn auto key on and animate the gain during playback. This functionality works for all the audio timeline effects. However, when it comes to the gain audio effects, you can adjust the volume using the rubber banding in the sequence segments. For the moment, I'll turn the audio waveforms off so you can see this more clearly. I'll enable edit and ensure auto key is turned on. I'll right-click on the gain slider and set a keyframe. I'll move further down the sequence and adjust the gain slider again, which will set another keyframe. At this point, you can click and drag the keyframes in the segment to adjust the audio level. Holding shift and dragging can constrain the adjustment either vertically or horizontally. Please be aware that you can only adjust keyframes and not the line between the keyframes. Moving further down the sequence, I will set another keyframe using the set key operation. And finally, at the end of the segment, I'll set the gain slider back to zero. So essentially, I've created a fade up and fade down in the rubber banding. If you go to the audio pull-down menu and turn on the waveform with effects, you will see the generated waveform displays the changes.
Tonight on X-Ball.
The final audio effects that I would like to quickly show you is the audio EQ tool. I'll select the segment, add an effect, and choose Audio EQ. You can adjust the parameters in the toolbar above the sequence, but let's go into the Advanced Editor and do some adjustments there. I'll ensure Auto Key is turned on, and I'll scrub to the beginning of the segments. So I'll press play and adjust the audio during playback. So if I scrub back to the beginning and play the segment, you can see and hear the audio animations. With Auto Key on, you can record and re-record the adjustments as many times as you like. This new recording will replace the previous animation with the new one. And finally, you can always access the animation editor to adjust the animated curve. One extra piece of knowledge worth knowing is that you can generate animation based on audio through the animation editor, but I'll save that video for another time. Now that you've seen a lot of audio functionality in the sequence, let's shift our focus to the mapping input and output path of audio in Smoke using the AudioDesk. To see the AudioDesk, you must go to the Viewer drop-down menus and choose to see a single player. In the Viewing Options pull-down menu, you will be able to enable the AudioDesk. Please note that you can only see the AudioDesk in the single player. Looking at the AudioDesk, you might refer to this as an audio mixer in other software. In Smoke, you can play up to 32 tracks of audio, and this all is mapped through the AudioDesk. Each audio strip represents an audio channel and also acts as a digital VU meter for your audio. The audio strips can also be paired up for stereo audio. So looking at strip 1 and strip 2, you can pan the sound to the correct outputs for doing stereo mixing. You can also mute and solo specific audio outputs in the AudioDesk to only hear certain sounds. The audio strips control the overall volume for its assigned track in the sequence. This is different to applying the gain timeline effects to the segment, which only adjusts the volume for that particular segment in the sequence. Like audio timeline effects, you can turn on Auto Key and keyframe the input volume of the audio track. You can also play this in real time and do your audio adjustments on the fly. Now I would like to spend some time on clarifying the path of audio with Smoke, or what I call audio mapping. At the bottom of the strips are numbers assigned for audio inputs. Imagine these are input connectors on a physical audio mixer for microphones, etc. At the top of the strips are the audio outputs from the mixer. Imagine these are the output connectors on your physical mixer that you would patch into a VTR or audio recorder. The general idea is that the audio is fed into the inputs of the AudioDesk, and then you can pipe the mixed output to any output from the AudioDesk. So how does this work in the context of Smoke? Well, audio first starts in the sequence as audio tracks. You will notice in the patch panel that each audio track has a small square block with a number. The numbers are the audio inputs feeding into the bottom of the AudioDesk. These are matched to the numbers at the bottom of each audio strip in the AudioDesk. For example, audio track 1 in the sequence is going to audio input 1 on the AudioDesk. This is the path of the audio for audio track 1 in the sequence. You can click and drag the box to the left and right and choose which audio input into the AudioDesk you would like this particular audio track to be patched to. If the box is empty, then this audio track is not patched to the AudioDesk inputs, therefore you will not hear the audio segments on this track. Normally Smoke automates all the audio mapping for you, but it is important to know about this because these outputs are the audio channel outputs on your hardware or discrete channel outputs for files exported from Smoke. The final topic I'd like to cover in audio is how do you know what you're actually hearing through your audio speakers? Even though your audio could be patched to 8 outputs via the AudioDesk, you could still monitor all the audio through a stereo pair of speakers. In the Preferences menu, the default setting for audio monitoring is set to stereo mixdown. This is simply to hear your audio correctly. It does not mess with the final audio outputs. In the next video, you'll complete your getting started journey into Smoke by learning how to export your clips and sequences.